Welcome back to the roundtable. Our conversation on the pain of divorce continues. So earlier on, we heard from Ruth. She was able to share with us what her story is. And joining me right now, I have Geoffrey Wanjala. Geoffrey has been divorced for the last 6 years, and he's going to be sharing with us, obviously, what led to the divorce and the lessons that he has learned from it. Welcome to the roundtable.
Thank you.
So Geoffrey, you were married for 20 years.
Yeah, today I think it should have been 24 by 29th of March.
So by the time you were getting divorced though, it was 20 years of marriage.
It was, yeah, we can say 20 plus.
And so walk me through it. Like, what eventually led to the breakdown of the marriage?
Basically, what led to the breakdown of the marriage is a change of expectations amongst ourselves. And it's also more around the values, the core values that are, sooner or later, I found out that we espouse different core values. And as it is, what you hold as a core value, you have to live for it. Yeah. So, and that one basically informs how you're going to behave, how you're going to relate. And so, as time went by, that's what I found out. And that one ended.
20 years in, how many kids?
Yeah, I've got 3 kids, 2 young adults and a daughter, yeah.
And at the point where now you both made the decision to get the divorce, was it mutual?
It was not mutual as such, because it came in, it was almost like, no, I'm now tired of this marriage.
From now your ex-spouse?
From my former spouse.
Yeah.
And so said she wants out, and you can't hold an adult back. Yeah.
And was it the first time that perhaps you'd both reached the point of considering that maybe we need to get a divorce, or was it something that was very sudden?
It was not the first time, because initially I'd gone out, I decided that I want to divorce her. And at least 2 years we were separated, because I was processing my divorce then, all right? Because of the things that I thought I'd already spoken about, things that I knew that I had given them time, because, you know, just the way you want to say, you know, there's some rain beating us.
For sure.
And then you only find out actually you're the one who's being rained on.
And maybe let's just take a couple of years back. Take us back to the beginning. Tell us about your love story, just to understand, because I think that's the thing that most people usually can't reconcile when it comes to the pain of divorce. Because the reality is that this is someone that you loved once upon a time, someone that you had chosen for better or for worse, but somewhere along the way, you know, things changed.
Yeah, well, almost a quarter of a decade ago. That's quite some time back to try and remember. And so, it just started out as a friendship, basically. A friendship, and I was still young. I was still in college by that time. And so we dated for about 2 years, and we got married.
And were you the same age at the point where you were getting married? Because like with Ruth's case, there was a big age difference.
Mm-hmm,
yeah.
Mm-hmm. I think she's 2 years my junior.
So pretty much,
yeah,
peers.
Pretty much. So yeah, so we got married, and we started off, well, just like, can I say everybody?
Everybody.
So it's assumed, eyes. Actually. we started out well, but way into the marriage, started noticing things that needed correction. We needed to adjust. And so I talked with her. It was not like disappearing into the night and never coming back, but seeking for help, because as a believer, that's the way we go. We seek for help, ask for help, because there's no shame in asking for help. But it's always different when you are asking to get some help and your partner does not see the need of the help.
And you know, Ruth put it so beautifully, where she was like, she just felt that at some point she was losing her dignity as a person. And you know, when you talk about divorce, usually people will focus on the process itself, not necessarily realizing for those people in the relationship, it starts way before, at the point that the relationship is falling apart, because you have to go through all these emotions, some positive, some negative. So what was that process like for you, especially as a man?
As a man, I find it interesting that you ask as a man. I thought you'd say as a human being.
As a human being, for sure. But, you know, because people assume that men don't feel it. Mm. And I kid you not that a lot of people watching this will usually blame the man for the divorce. Mm. Mm-hmm. And you see, in her case, and obviously that's her experience, whereby she was like, she was in a marriage with someone who was avoidant and emotionally unavailable. Mm-hmm. So it's pretty obvious that who of the two did not want it to work. Mm-hmm. But then here you come, and you're a man, and your experience is actually the complete opposite, because then if things had gone your way, for sure, you'd still be in a marriage today.
Definitely.
But it was your ex-wife who chose that she's done.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm sure that must have gutted you.
Of course, it was painful. Men have feelings too.
Yeah.
Okay? Away with the stereotype that men cannot feel anything.
Yeah.
Mostly, I think the reason why people would want to think that men don't feel a thing is because the moment the divorce is happening, actually the process, they could be having a rebound relationship already.
Yeah, because that's how men deal. It doesn't mean they're not hurting, but most of the time that's how they choose to deal.
Some of them choose to deal with it that way. Some of them, not all of them.
Yeah, all of them.
Okay, so that's the reason why I think people would want to think like that. But I did hurt, and I did hurt, okay? It's only because I live with my children. So the only place that I could go is into the bathroom, go and cry my heart out, then come back and be strong for my children. But you see, the children, even if they're there, it's not lost to them because they can see your demeanor. They can see how you, they can pick it up.
You know, the energy.
Yeah, like my daughter one time just told me, "Dad, sometimes you look so sad, sometimes you look so happy." You see, all the emotions, you know, sometimes you're happy, sometimes you're sad. So they'll pick it up. They'll pick it up. My second born is so outspoken, and it's just like, and around that time I was not employed, so it was
even tougher.
So, and he would go like, "You know, Daddy, I just want him to get a job. At least he won't sit there and he won't be."
You'll have a distraction.
Yes, yes. So the pain is there, and it is very real, because you're talking of shattered dreams. You're talking of things that you really were thinking of.
Your family is fractured.
Yes.
You know, there's this person you've invested in who you're no longer allowed to love, because a lot of the times that's what people feel.
Yeah, people feel that way, and that's the way I felt, okay? As much as, yes, it was more of like, okay, fine, you want to go, it's okay, you can go. But I think for me, the breaking point of it is when I realized that she had just gotten married just after getting the papers.
Right.
You know,
and it makes you start to think that, when did this relationship start?
Exactly. And I think that's where it really, you know, sometimes when you say, okay, fine, you want a divorce, okay, fine, you want out, and she goes, it's like, okay, fine, let's wait. She might come back.
Right.
But then when she gets married, or when he gets married,
it's final.
Then that's the time it was quite a tough time around that time.
And you know, just hearing you speak, you mentioned that you're the one who is currently has custody of the kids. Probably just explain to us that situation, because again, that's unique, because in most cases it's the woman or the mother who ends up with the kids.
My situation is unique because we divorced. She's not in the country, so she's out of the country, so by default I remain with the kids.
Right.
And one of the things that I really appreciate her for is not pulling the kids into our mire. Okay, and I wouldn't have allowed that. I would have rather, if it was going to be about custody, I would have allowed her to have the children, because children are important. We don't need to fight over them and to, you know, create such trauma. They're already traumatized because of the relationship that is not working. So I have the children because she's out of the country. She lives outside the country.
And it was a mutual decision.
I don't think she had a choice, because she doesn't live here. So,
right.
Yeah.
And how do you think your kids handle the divorce?
I talked with them, especially when I realized that the mother had gotten married. So I talked with them and I told them, yeah, fine. At least for the two, because they'd seen us separating some time back. So for the two, at least they said, okay, it's almost like, yeah, it has happened again, isn't it?
Because they were old enough.
They were old enough, yeah. So for the two, I just explained to them. I told them, fine, your mom got married. And so that's what is happening. For the younger one, my daughter, that one was it was difficult.
How old was your daughter?
you're talking of 6 minus 12, so she was 6 years, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So it was difficult for me to bring the news to her that first of all we are divorced,
and secondly, usually at that age they don't even understand what that word means.
They do.
Yeah.
Tamima, they do.
They understand the word divorce and the process.
They do. These kids, they're so smart. Yeah, they do. So I explained to her, and when I explained to her, she said, I understand, it's okay.
Wow.
Yeah. And because that one was my greatest fear. In my house, we have this mirror, and she would pass then, she would start dancing. And my question was, will my daughter dance again?
Yeah. Mm. And did she dance again?
Thank God she did.
Mm. And is the mother actively in the kid's life now?
Yeah, she is so active. She's a good mother. I'll give that to her.
So you're co-parenting?
Sort of. Yes, sort of. We are.
It's easier because she's basically not here physically.
Basically, we are co-parenting because she's in their lives.
For sure.
And in a very good way.
And I guess we have to commend you as a man, because most people could have used their bitterness at their spouse moving on to almost keep the kids away, but you didn't. Yeah, you allowed her to still be part and parcel of their lives.
I take it, my own view is this, and this is what I hold to. They are my children 100%, just as much as they are her children 100%. And she must have access to them. And if she didn't, if she ignored them, I think that one would really be bad for me and for the children as well. Because children need their parents. It doesn't matter what has happened between the parents. Yeah, it's not about the children, it's about us. So can we just sort our own mess and give the children what they need, because they need us.
For sure.
Yeah.